Hello everyone, SP Architects here. DeFi Finder 2.6 released. There are too many new features. In this tutorial, we will only focus some of them. We will create an animation, which is going to be a drone rendering animation. Of course, for this reason, we are going to use DeFi Finder new camera system. With the new camera system, we can arrange cameras as splines. We can change their path with splines, and now we can manage them easily as we want. Alright, as you can see, our scene completely empty. Now we are going to create a scene. To do that, I will need a plane. Let's go to assets and type in plane. And after that, let's go to model. We will click this and place here. Now the size is not enough for this tutorial. Let's multiply by 10. So we go to size and input here one additional zero. And now we have a very wide terrain. After that, we will change this texture. You can do it with two different ways in D5. You can change only material. Let's hit the eye. Pick up that material from here and you will see this material template. Let's click that and click grass. It's generating right now, and now you will see a grass field. There are benefits and unbenefits using this grass texture. It's easy to use. You can change the settings with only one click, but it consumes too much memory and doubles your render time more than twice. In the final, if the time won't be a problem for you, you can use this grass material. If time is a problem for you, well, you can just go to custom and you will assign only a simple grass texture. Let's go to base color map, click this texture and assign your own texture. I say assigning your own texture because unfortunately D5 textures are suck. Now I'm going to use my own texture. Alright, I have assigned my own texture, but it's too big. Let's fix it from here, from the tree planner. Let's enable it, and we will barely see its true size, but actually it's going to be multiplied by 3, and this is my texture. As you can see, it's so repeatable, it's too bad for a scene. You can fix this by new feature of 2.6 with the this UV randomizer. As you can see, it's seamless because I'm going to use 3D grass and the repeating tile won't be visible for me. Now we will click this icon and click scatter. Now it goes to nature automatically. From here, I will select this ornamental grass. And as you can see, free first is selected. I will only see free elements. And from here, and as you can see, I have tried this grass 04 before and marked as favorite. I'm going to select it. And from the left bottom of the window, you can change its properties. Now radius at the maximum, it use scatter. If I reduce this radius, it's going to be a simple brush. Now I'm testing it. The scale is not correct. Let's fix it from here. It's going to be something like this. And density is not enough. Let's increase. And this is what I want. And by the way, I'm going to turn off the auto exposure. And my target is to match the color with the texture and the 3D grass. To achieve it, I will select my texture and go to base color, and I will decrease this V value. Now they are nearly similar. Maybe I can change the saturation or hue. Yeah, there we go. Now as you can see, we have lost our brush. To select our brush, we will click this texture, and from the right of the window you will see brush recourse, and we have this brush history 1. Let's click this apply to brush, and to delete this we will hit alt. We can delete like so. or now I'm holding Alt and I'm going to bring this slider to right. And now, as you can see, it's kind of scattered, but delete scattered. Let's click here and we have rid of all of the grass. Now let's increase this slider to maximum and paint. Let's zoom inside a little and there we can see our grass. If we zoom out, we can see it because it's for performance issues. With this system, you can work with your projects faster and smoother. Now, in order to correct the scale, I will just place a car. To do it, I will go to model and let's collapse this nature. Click vehicle and I will select this small size. Actually, all of them are pro version. We can only place some of them as free, unfortunately, and I think these are not useful. Yeah, I don't want to place Neve Energy Car for a renders. It's also electric too. It's also another electric. We have only one car to place as free, which is not elegant. Anyway, thanks D5. Now let's stop these wheels from here. Click this dynamic, click driver. We won't need a driver. And maybe black is okay. And grass maybe, but I want to fix that. Let's click this. And I will delete all. And reduce the size a little. And reduce the density. Let's look at what we have. Yeah, way more better. Now for our tutorial, I will place a couple of trees from the nature. I like to using conifer trees. I click it and place a couple of conifer trees, maybe like this again. Now lighting is too bad. I cannot determine where I will place. I will change the precise to smooth. Yeah, way more better. Let's place other kinds of trees and maybe this one. Before placing it, I can change the scale. We will just hit the C. Let's switch back to precise and look at what we have. I want to scale up them. Maybe 4 meters. Yeah, way more better. And after that, I will select all of the trees, hit the shift and drag. Let's move our car to here. Maybe changing their scale randomly will get better results. Oh, by the way, we have a new feature, walking, but we are in the trees stuck. Let's fly and let's click walk again and we can walk. Yeah, very nice. We can walk, but I have bad news for you. As you can see, I'm changing the camera, follow my mouse, and my mouse stops here and camera stops. Again, my mouse is moving and camera stops. I cannot turn my head to left or right. It stucks also here, also here. It's a very bad problem. By the way, I have reported this issue to officials and reporting this problem for 1 year, but I'm sorry, they are ignoring me. If you use TVMotion, you won't see problems like that. You can change very easily your cameras. Look your behind in TVMotion. You won't get problems like that, and they listen their community. Anyway, maybe we can change the sky, or our new feature is new HDRIs. We can reach it from here, HDRI, and we can select one of them like this. This one maybe. Oh, this is very dark. Maybe we can fix it. I don't know. Maybe this sunset. Cloudy for overcast scenes. Not bad. We can use it. But I want to use a sunny HDRI. But all of them sunset. Sunset. Even pros are sunset or cloudy. Yeah, they are not useful for midday rendering. For sunny days, we have only this one, which has too many clouds and very blue. Anyway, let's fix this error. Maybe we can change the effects. We can change the white balance, but before it, I will add some sun. Way more better. Maybe 2 is going well. And sky is very turquoise. Maybe we can fix it from here. Okay, it's not working. Maybe to fix the sky, we can go to effects and change the white balance. Like this. And also we have some new features here. Highlight local exposure and shadow local exposure. This highlight local exposure works as, let's say that we are looking from this direction. Not moving, there is an invisible thing here. Anyway, let's go apply. And now I will change highlight local exposure. If I increase this, now we will see the sky unexposed and we have very dark shadows here. I will increase this and this shadow will be brighter and we will see details, barely details. We must see a line here, but it's not working correctly. I think there is a bug here. Anyway, maybe we can fix it from shadow. Yeah, as you can see, I'm reducing the shadow. Now I can see the details, this line. But our scene is desaturated right now. I don't like this effect. Maybe we can combine them. Like so. I think the solution is changing car's color. Let's right click them. And make them default. By the way, I will hit the I and select my texture and reduce it and increase the size to 8. Yeah, way more better. Let's click the car and change its color. Anyway, let's record our camera. Let's go to animation and here the new feature. We can place predetermined camera angles. We will just click it and if we play, we will see this. Now let's place this movement amid of the scene. To do that, we will click this and click edit path. If we go up and move like this, if we click this point, we can move it too. By the way, we can change their settings from here also. Like this. Let's click done. Maybe 400. Let's play. And this is what we get. And by the way, you can duplicate to make continuous animation. But I'm not going to use this. I'm going to delete. There we go. I will move this car to here. Let's duplicate this and I'm going to delete this car. By the way, I'm duplicating this with Ctrl plus D. Let's go to camera. Alright, now I'm targeting here at current view. Let's go here and turn to here. Maybe we can go here. Place another one. Here and maybe we can pass through from here, fly and return. Let's look at what we have. As you can see, it's looking wrong direction and make crazy things. With the new feature of 2.6, we will be able to fix. Let's click our animation. Click edit path And now we can see clearly our pads. For instance, this area is very sharp. First, I click this point and I will be able to see our desired points. By clicking them, we can fix them too. Now it's way more smoother. Let's make this smoother. Also, we can move it to here. Important thing is the distance between the points must be equal. It's a bit hard to move. Let's go to display, click smooth. Click this bezier. Let's make smoother. And our camera will be follow this direction near the tree. Alright, let's look at what we have. Our preview is here. Here we have a problem. Let's fix our head. Let's click this point and rotate. It's hitting the tree. Maybe it will be a good idea to change the elevation this point. Way more better. Let's rotate a little. Too much. Let's go back. Again, it's looking wrong direction. Yeah, way more better. It hits trees. Which tree? This tree. Alright, no problem. Let's move the tree. The easier way of doing that. This is a very sharp turning. Let's fix this camera. Alright, way more better. And also it has the yaw. By the way, I want to add a yaw effect to here. Maybe by turning this camera like so. Let's make this a very smooth. Yeah, there we go. Let's click precise and look at what we have. Wonderful. Way more better. I will render this with a couple of settings and watch the animation together. Alright guys, this is our render. Thank you for watching. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section below. Until next time, have a nice day.